Good evening, everyone. Low snow and lonely, I'm a friend of Jason's. When Jason asked me to be the best man, I quickly said yes. Then it dawned on me that I would have to write a speech. Now, I've never had to write a speech before, so I went to a reliable source for inspiration. I went to the I searched and searched for a few hours and found some great stuff. Unfortunately, none of it had to do with writing those speeches. You know what I mean. Jason and I have been friends for quite some time now. He has always been there for me. One day that comes to mind is the 19th. Jason, being a true friend of mine, wanted to do something special for me. He wanted to buy the last drink for me. We went up to the bar at Chili's, and he ordered two shots of Zambuca for us. He asked me if I'd ever done a flaming Zambuca before. I told him I had not. Not being my 19th birthday and very late, and I imagine what kind of shape I was in. Jason grabs a shot, lights it on fire, and shoots it back at the pro. Makes it look very easy. He then gives me two pieces of advice. Don't touch the lip of the glass, and then just throw it back. Well, you tell a drunk guy to throw a shot back, I end up missing my mouth and lighting my face on fire. I try and put the flames out of my hands, and Jay, being a true friend of mine, he's actually trying to blow out the flames. Not realizing that he's actually adding more fuel to the fire. I'm so surprised that I'm not even surprised to this day. But seriously though, we've been friends now for 10 plus years, and in that time, he has proven himself to be not only a great friend, but a truly great man as well. I value my friendship with Jason, and I look forward to having the same great friendship as love for you guys now. And a wonderful thing about Della, she has made Jason happier than I've ever seen. Today is a day of joy and happiness for all of us, but it's not just a day. It's a very special beginning of a new life between Jason and Della. I wish you both health and happiness for the rest of your lives. I'd like to... everyone to raise a glass and join me for a toast.
Cheers.
Thanks, Chris. A lady was sitting in her house one night, a single lady. She thinking she maybe wants to get married. So she put her down in the paper, and she's had friends that are married and seen a lot. So she put her down in the paper that looking for a good man who wouldn't beat her or wouldn't run away from her, and he was good in bed. So a couple days later, the doorbell rings. So she goes to the door and answers, and this guy's sitting there in a wheelchair. She looks at him, and the guy says, "Well, I'm here to answer your ad." And the lady says, "How can you help me? He's got no arms and no legs." He says, "Well, I got no arms. I can't beat you. I got no legs. I can't run away from you." He says, "Well, that's fine." He says, "I need somebody that's good in bed too." And the guy says, "Well, how do you think I rang your doorbell?" Anyways, I'm going to call on Della's mother, Gloria Clemens.
Hello, everybody. Anyway, welcome.
mowing stuff, decorating the dresses, and a special thank you to two boys. Where are they? Bob and Rob. They were with us all supper last night and made awesome potato salad, I have to mention. It's all so much appreciated. Bella Grayson, you two look absolutely amazing. What a sweet couple. You know, Bella, when she was a little girl, she would always look in the mirror and say, aren't you pretty, Mommy? And we were pretty then, and we were so pretty. But it makes the rooms turn into look so wonderful, and what a wonderful wedding. We are so proud of you, Della. As a little girl, Della was outgoing, strong, and loving, which she has carried into her adult life. Most of her growing up years were filled with many friends, as you can see today, and watching her dancing, her solos, duos, and groups, which she has many awards for. I'm sure Della will be showing some of those moves tonight. One little story about Della's teenage life of being grounded. She spent the night in a room downstairs, sobbing, we thought. We were upstairs playing cards, listening to music. So after a while, a couple hours, I thought I would go down and give her a kiss and say goodnight. I opened the door, and it was filled with friends. They all came through the window. So being a mean mother, I made them all fall out the way they came out. Sorry, guys, I'm sure some of you are here. But you probably ruined my flowers. We are so proud to welcome Jason into our family. As our son and brother to Marcy, Kristen, and Tyson. We just have to destroy those flying helicopters. But we love you with all our heart. A little story about brotherly love. The night before Jason's stag, I was down with Del and Jason. I was concerned about Ty going with these big dogs, paintballing, drinking beer, and golfing. Jay said, Mom, don't worry. I will look after him. So, when Ty seen Ty the next day, I didn't see him that night, he had these huge welts on him. I'm like, what is that from, Ty? And he's like, oh, Mom, it's just Jay. Della and Jason, you two are such a wonderful couple. We have so much fun with you guys, whether it be fishing or just hanging out, of course, cooking meals. Jay, of course, has the killer breakfast. Dr. Della, as Ty calls her, is so caring to her sisters, Kirsten and Marcy, up in Saskatoon. For when they are sick, she is always there for their needs, usually treats. Well, Dad and Jason, I guess I should give you some marriage advice. Since Dad and I have been married for 28 years today. Happy anniversary to Jay's parents, Neil and Judy. Thank you for raising such a wonderful son. To all our loved ones that have passed on, like Grandpa Mawson and Grandpa Clemens, I'm sure they're with us today. Let's raise our glasses to a wonderful couple and a long and happy marriage. Mom and Dad. Dad and Jay. Oh yeah, one more thing. May all your troubles be little ones.
Lots of little ones. need practice, they can have this one.
Thanks, Gloria. Gloria is, she's my older sister, most of the time. I'd like to call on Emil, Jason's dad. He's got a few words.
Well, I wasn't going to come up here because the last time I did a speech was my oldest wedding, Francine. And she complained about the whole thing because I spoke too long. And all I kept talking about was drinking and driving. So anyhow, since Gloria did such a wonderful speech, she covered just about everything, so I could say ditto for the whole thing. And congratulations on your 20 plus year 28. And like I always said, and Jason knows it, you can't keep your wife happy, you ain't happy. Anyhow, hopefully Jason and Della, will be stable. Jason didn't have a very stable life because I was in the military when we were all good at work. Jason managed to go, some of the stories we didn't tell about this, he actually went to Austria to learn how to ski, like Della learned how to snowboard. She broke her wrist, Jason broke his thumb. We found out later that it wasn't a skiing accident, it was actually horsing around on the bins. It was on the first day there, and we had spent a lot of money, so the doctor was kind enough to just wrap his cast around the pole and throw him down the hill. So I guess they're a fit couple, they're both prone to accidents, and hopefully the accidents they'll have in the future will all be their little running type. I come from a big family. I know a lot of them. I said it was going to be short, didn't I? Anyhow, I come from a big family. I've met a lot of wonderful family members. I actually met Della's parents, or except her dad, but her mother. I met her for the first time yesterday. So it took us about 2 years plus to meet, but we finally met. We couldn't get away. So here I am. On my side of the family, we have 3 kids, me and Judy. And the biggest family that we have on my side is 21. So don't try to beat the record, but be somewhere in between. That would be okay. So to all my friends, to all my new relatives through this wedding, and everybody that came here tonight, thank you very much. Have a great time. And let's enjoy the couple's life.
Jacob Zerner, happy birthday.